Number two. Where is number two?
Assalamualaikum, doctor.
Waalaikumsalam, warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
First of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Yueni. I'm from Thailand, actually, and I'm studying here in Islamic finance and banking. I would like to express my gratitude as I'm so overwhelming having been a part of this event. However, my question to you is about the role of Muslimah professional, as nowadays the woman position has been considered differently from the past. Like, women can be the leader, women can work outside, but if we looking for into the Quran or our hadith, actually women are not allowed going without mahram or anything else. And also there is the idea which is in gender equity. So to summarize my questions again, your suggestion to the Muslimah professional role. Thank you.
If I understood the question correctly, the sister is saying that now there are Muslimas also who are professional women. Is there gender equity in Islam? And can a woman do all the jobs? If I understand the question correctly. Sister, if you hear my talk on women's rights in Islam, Islam believes in equality between men and women. Men and women are equal, but they aren't identical. Men and women are equal, but they aren't identical. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the woman different than the man. Biologically, they're different. Physically, they're different. Psychologically, they're different. Each has a different role. I cannot say, you know, I'm equal to the woman, therefore I want to become a mother. I cannot. Can I become a mother? Cannot. A woman, she's a mother. Allah has made biologically a woman. She is meant to be a better mother, a man. A woman can take care of a child better than a man. We have in the Western world women going for work and the father doing babysitting. Upside down world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our beloved Prophet Muhammad, is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari. Before I give this hadith, I would like to give a brief. That overall men and women are equal, but they are not identical. I'd like to give an example. If suppose in examination, there are many students appearing for the examination, two of them, they come out first. Student A, he gets 80 out of 100, student B gets 80 out of 100. There are 10 questions, each carrying 10 marks. If you analyze the answer sheet, in answer number 1, student A gets 9 out of 10, student B gets 7 out of 10. So in answer number 1, student A has advantage over student B. In answer number 2, B gets 9 out of 10, student A gets 7 out of 10. So in answer number 2, student B has advantage over A. In the remaining 8 questions, both of them get 8 out of 10. If you add up, both get 80 out of 100, they're equal. But in answer to question 1, student A has the degree of advantage. In answer to question 2, student B has the degree of advantage. Similarly, men and women overall are equal. In some aspects, they aren't equal. Not in all the aspects. They're biologically different, physically different, psychologically different. So depending upon the psychological nature and the biological nature, the roles are different. Some, both can do. Majority think both can do. Some things only women can do, man cannot do. Something only man can do, woman cannot do. So depending upon the background, it is distributed. Overall, they are equal. For example, if a robber enters my house, you know, I'll not tell my wife, women and men are equal, go and fight. I'll not tell my daughter, go and fight. Men and women are equal. Because Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nisa chapter 4, verse number 35, that Allah, men, the men are the protectors of the women. Ar-rijalu qawwamuna 'ala an-nisa. The men are the protectors of women because Allah has given them more strength. Where it comes to motherhood, When it comes to motherhood, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the hadith I wanted to quote to you, in Sahih Bukhari, in the book of Adab, chapter number 2, hadith number 2, our beloved Prophet, there was a man who asked the Prophet, who deserves the maximum love and companionship in this world? The Prophet said, your mother. The man asked after that too, the Prophet said, your mother. The man asked after that too, the Prophet said for the third time, your mother. The man asked after that too, then the Prophet said, your father. That means 75% of the love and companionship goes to the mother. 25% goes to the father. That means mother gets the gold medal, she gets the silver medal, also the bronze medal. The father has to be satisfied with the consolation prize. I cannot say, what is this? I want to be mother. No, you cannot be. So you have to understand men and women are equal. Now, this Western world talking about women liberalization, even they don't consider men and women equal. If men and women are equal, when they run a 100 meters race, do men and women run together? Yes or no, sister? Do they run together? When they run a 100 meters race in the Olympics, do men and women run together 100 meters? Huh? Why? If they are equal, they should run together. Why not? Because even the Western world knows men and women in physical activity are different, run differently. If you are running together, it is not correct, it's inequality. Do you understand? But when you sit for an examination in your college, do you sit together or not? Same paper? So many times it's equal. But sometimes, biologically they're different. You cannot say, I will have 100 meters dashed together. Football is different. Men different, women different. So what you have to realize, the Western world also believes in it. But they are giving false talk of women's liberalization. In the garb of women's liberalization, they are degrading our sisters, our mothers. It is nothing, the Western talk of women liberalization is nothing but a disguised form of exploitation of a body, degradation of a soul. The Western talk of women liberalization is actually, they are selling our daughters and making, in the name of art and culture, they are utilizing our mothers and sisters. You know, you have had, when you see an advertisement of a motorcycle, who rides motorcycle more, girl or the man? Men or the woman in the world? Who rides more? Men. Invariably in a motorcycle ride, you'll find a woman. Why? Why? What the heck? Men are riding, so why do you show motor women? Why? They are utilizing our mothers and daughters and they are selling them. I was told about a very famous ad, the BMW. I was told. I have not seen it. One of the person told me a very famous BMW ad. There is a girl standing in front of the ad with bikini. And the ad says, test drive her now. Who, the girl or the car? What are they doing? They're selling our daughters. They're selling our mothers. And talking about women's rights. You have to be very careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given men and women are equal in Islam. But they are not identical. Depending upon the physiological nature, biological nature, many a times they have the same role, many a time they have different roles. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Brother at the back, please.